Okay, creating substrings. Yeah, this is important. I'm just gonna show it really quick. You wanna have a substring of a string. Let's print it out to the screen. Let's get rid of this new string that was just from the code I copied from the site. Let's just say str1.substring, and it's pretty obvious what substring does. It, you know, gives you a piece of that string, beginning index 5. You can just provide a beginning index or a beginning and end index. What does that mean? Well, that means if I put 5, it'll just cut from 5 to the end. Run that. Oh my God, I could have run it like with two things. Whatever. You can see how substring works, of course. Let's now combine two things. Let's now let's see. We want to print out. We want to find some word and print out from it to the end of the string. So let's do that. Let's do sout. We're looking for the word house, so str1. We're doing substring from where? From wherever we find. Let's just make it a variable just so it's easier for you to see. Index, create a local variable index. Oh my God. Index equals str1.index of how. So now we want to see where how is, and we want to cut from how to the end of the string. For example, that's our task. I mean, it's not really that complex. So now we get the index and we pass the index here, and it'll just, you know, we can combine these two. We could have also said str1.index of here, index of how, and you understand how this is basically the same, you know, as creating a variable, but this is way less readable, you know, just chaining a bunch of things inside of here. I mean, not really recommended. Why not create an extra variable? Now it's much clearer what we're trying to do. So if we run this now, how are you? It's just this part. For example, what if I wanted to also substring from that, but I also wanted to give it an end index? And how would I do that? Well, for example, I just want to give you an example in Android. In Android, I have this kind of message, and there's a way in Android to paint a part of the message. So basically, there is some component that you put a text on. It's called a text view. Basically, it's called like this, text view. It's just a view that displays text. And it has a way to paint a part of the text. I only wanted how to be read, you know? So I would say something like text view, paint. And we're gonna now do that with just printing. We only wanna print how, but imagine it was, instead of printing, it was painting it blue, you know? How do we do that? Well, I need to find out where that word begins. For example, I have something like Milan, a message would be something like, congrats, Milan won the prize, something like that. And where Milan would be any name, you know, that would be string name equals something. And I would, you know, create a string with, you know, congrats translated into many languages, add on to that my name, and won the prize translated into many languages. So I'm not sure where this would be, you know, maybe in some language, congratulations would have 50 letters, 20 letters, and so on. I need to exactly figure out the position of my name inside of my message. That's my task in Android, and I'm working Android in Java. So basically what would I do? Well, I would do something like, and now let's create a string full message, something like that. And let's have this be our full message. Okay. Well, that was just a bunch of stuff, right? Okay. So basically, this is my full message, and I'm just going to make it even more realistic by adding the name here, plus plus name. Okay. So this is how I would create a message, right? Some name comes in. We're hard coding it here, but imagine this information came from a database or a server. You know, we're playing an online game and you want to print to everyone, congrats, you won the prize, right? That's our task. So now I create a message like this. Again, this is hard coded, but imagine in Android, there's a way to have all these words come from a file, which is translatable, and congrats may have 20 letters in some language and 7 in another, you know. I want to find where name is inside of this string and just paint that part. How would I do that? Well, I would call something like paint, on on where you find it plus the length. We're going to be printing instead of painting because there's no paint in the console. I'm going to say print me the substring of full message. So full message the substring starting where. I'm going to create variables just so it's easier for you to see. I don't want to put everything inside of this bracket. So I'm just going to call it start index. I'm going to create a variable. Start index is going to be full message dot index of name, right? And end index. End index, I'm going to create a variable. Or what is the parameter here? It's end index. It's not length. If it was length, I could have said name dot length, but it's not length. It's the beginning, it's basically start index plus length, right? Because that's the end index, right? What would I else need to do if I was really doing a proper program? I would do something like if start index is not minus one. I need to make sure that this doesn't crash, because what if for any reason whatsoever, it doesn't find a name in there, you know? If the start index is not minus one, it found the name. So then imagine this was painting the text. And it's not, it's just printing out the name taken from here, you know. And here it is. Okay, so that's your usage of start, of index of, and substring. And you will be combining all of these methods on your own as well, I assume, in your homework.